श्री वैष्णव सिद्धांत निर्धारण सार्वभौम एट्रिब्यूट टू योर 1000 डिवाइन ईयर्स। श्री वैष्णव सिद्धांत निर्धारण सार्वभौम एट्रिब्यूट टू योर 1000 डिवाइन ईयर्स। Who you are? A philosopher? A spiritual leader? A literary giant? Or a social reformer? By a humble devotee. Who you are? Sri Vaishnava Siddhanta Nirdharana Sarvabhauma? When I strolled on the streets of Sri Perambadur, I just could not imagine that you were born there 1000 years ago and lived 20 and 100 years. You were a Hindu theologian, philosopher and scriptural exegete, born in a Tamil Brahmin family in the village of Sri Perambadur. You are also called as Sri Ramanujacharya, Udaivar, Yatiraja, Embermannar and Lakshmana Muni. You are the most important Acharya of our tradition. You followed Nadamuni and Yamunacharya. You are the leading expounder of Visishtadvaita, the dominant Vedanta school of Vedic philosophy. You were born to Asurikeshwar Somayaji Dikshitar and Kantimati. Your intelligence and ability to comprehend philosophical points were legendary. Your parents contemplated what you would be. The scholars did examine you from childhood. Like Vasistha named Lakshmana, seeing the brilliance in face, Periyathiru Malai Nambi, struck by the tejas of your face, named you after Lakshmana as Ilaya Perumal, emphasizing to be Adisheshu first, Lakshmana and Balarama next, and now you. You were born in Bharat, in the remote village, yet near to the cultural city of Chennai. To eradicate the Asuric Shastras engulfed around that were taking people away from Lord Vishnu. Tirukachinambi, an archak at Vardaraja temple, took you in protection when you lost your father. He became your mentor, guide and philosopher, who used to converse with Vardaraja himself. At young age of 16, you mastered all Vedas and Shastras, married Rakshakambal at the age of 17, unhappy with her attitudes and actions, embraced sannyas after 3 and 10 years. You were placed under Yadava Prakasha, a sannyasi, to train in Advaita Purva Paksha Shastra of Vedanta. Alavandar Yamunacharya of Sri Rangam visited you then, but could not speak to you for reasons unknown to you. Not happy with your arguments on Advaita, your guru tried to drown you in Ganga, but you were saved first by your Sakha Govinda and then by Lord Varadaraja and Perundevitayar. When you arrived for the last rites of Alavandar at Sri Rangam, you noticed his three fingers bent. Understanding his desire, You took the vow to fulfill his desire and saw them unfold. This laid path to your life's mission. Alavandar wanted you to come to Sri Rangam and write a commentary on Veda Vyasa's Brahma Sutras. Also, you would perpetuate the memory of Vyasa and Parasara, and you would strive to propagate Visishtadvaita on the lines of the 4,000 holy collects of Alvars. You accepted Yamunacharya as your Manasika Acharya, and you were introduced to Yamunacharya's philosophy by his disciple Mahapurna. You started travelling, had philosophical debates in various Vishnu temples. Many of them, after losing the debates, became your disciples. You stayed at Kanchi under the tutelage of Tirukachinambi, who obtained the famous six words from Lord Varadaraja and passed them to you. The famous six words became your jnana and janma mantras and led you to the path where you stand today with great empathy and telepathy. The six words provided the guidelines for you to follow, they being: Lord Narayana is the Paramatma and the other souls are different from Paramatma. Prapatti is the means to attain salvation and not the last remembrance. Moksha is only on death and you take refuge at the feet of Periyanambi. Your first step towards your yatra was to get Pancha Samskara at Vakula tree by Periyanambi, who initiated Dvaya Mantra at Madurantakam, which is named Dvayam Vilainadha Tirupati, and Lord Ranganatha called you Nammamudayavar when you started the work on Brahma Sutras. You were called Ramanuja Muni and also Yati Rajar by Lord Deva Yati Rajan. You requested Tiruku Kostiyur Nambi to initiate into the secrets of three mantras. Before you assumed the office of Acharya at Sri Rangam, bold as you are, told to your followers to follow the path of Moksha once you got the instruction. Acharya Tirukostiyur Nambi called you Empermannar when you answered him that you gave a spiritual wake-up call on his rage and declared that Sri Vaishnavism would henceforth be known as Ramanuja Darshanam, the light of Ramanuja. You had a truly unique personality, combining contemplative insight, logical acumen, Catholicity, charismatic energy and selfless dedication to God. Many followed you, walked along with you in dedication and determination. Even your old guru, Yadava Prakasa, became your disciple as Govinda Yogi. You met your guru, Tirukostiyur Nambi, at the banks of River Kaveri. You prostrated with bhakti, but he did not ask you to get up. That made your Sishya Kidambi Achan to cast aspirations at him, and your guru, with satisfied heart, left the world understanding you have good Sishyas to take care. On your spiritual travels, once Yajnamurti argued on illusion theory, but hearing your arguments, became your disciple and assumed the name as Arulal Perumal Empermannar and wrote Jnanasaram and Prameyasaram. Such was your spiritual and debating power that each went on following you. Thiruvarangattu Amudanar, the in charge of Sri Rangam temple, handed over the temple to you on the behest of your disciple Kuresan, known as Kurutalvan, who wrote Ramanuja Nuratadi of 108 verses, a part of holy collects of 4,000. Thus your Guru Shishya affection was established with dedication and authority. You treated all people as equal without considering their caste. At that time, low caste people were prohibited inside the temples. You let the low caste people into the temples in many places. You were hailed as social reformer, which many could not think, and you did it. You mastered the Bodhayana Vritti of sage Vyasa, wrote several works like Vedanta Sangraham, explaining the various viewpoints of Shankara, Yadava, Bhaskara and others, Vedanta Deepam, Gita Bhashyam, etc. Your literary works marked the dawn of new Yuga with Yuga Purusha in you. You completed the commentary on Sri Badarayana's Vedanta Sutra at 100th. In your Sri Bhashya, you described the three categories of reality, tattvas, God, soul and matter, which have been used by the later Vaishnava theologians. The principles of bhakti as a means to liberation, moksha, were also developed. You wrote the Vedanta Deepa and Vedanta Sara for understanding of Sri Bhashya. You refer to a commentary on Brahma Sutra by Bodhayana. In the opening verse of your commentary, you stated that your views are in accordance with Bodhayana. You emphasized in the first pada, first adhyaya of the sutra, may your mind be filled with devotion towards the highest Brahman, the abode of Lakshmi, who produces, sustains and reabsorbs the entire universe, whose only aim is to foster the manifold classes of beings that humbly worship him. You wrote that which was brought up of the Upanishads, which restores to life the souls whose vital strength had departed, owing to the heat of the fire of transmigratory existence, which was well guarded. May intelligent men daily enjoy that it is now presented to them in your words. In the second pada, you mentioned that we have maintained that this highest being has a divine form peculiar to itself, not made of the stuff of Prakriti, and not due to Karman designating it by terms such as ether or breath, which generally denote that same highest self which is different from all beings. In the third pada, you illustrated that heaven and earth is the highest Brahman. You also cleared that beyond the senses there are the objects, beyond the objects there is the mind, beyond the mind there is the intellect, the great self is beyond the intellect. You reiterated that beyond the great there is the unevolved, and beyond the unevolved there is the person. Beyond the person there is nothing. This is the goal, the highest road. Your explanation of Brahma Sutras opened the minds of many. Your famous Gadyatrayam of Saranagati, Sri Ranga and Sri Vaikuntha opened the path of moksha. Your Grandha Nityam opened the minds of Purusha. And Lord himself appeared at Thirukkuram Kudi as a Sri Vaishnava and got Samasrayanam from Udaivar. Is it not a miracle by you or Lord? Your Vaikuntha Gadyam, written in Sanskrit, is a prayer for Lord Vishnu. It is one of the first bhakti prayers in Sri Vaishnavism. It is recited in the 108 Divya Desam temples, including Srirangam, as of day. Just see how we all remember you with utmost adoration and bhakti. Vaikuntha Gadyam gives a detailed description of Vaikuntha, seen through the eyes of a liberated one, Mukti Jivan. You asked us to surrender to Lord Narayana's lotus feet. Narayana Sayujyam, Salokyam, Sarupyam and Samipyam and Kaimarakyam made it a must. Sriranga Gadyam is also a prayer, a detailed description of the god Ranganatha as Jnana, Bala, Aishwarya, Virya, Shakti, Agni, Sausilya, Vatsalya, Madhava, Arjava, Sauharda, Samya, Karunya, Madhurya, Gambhirya, Audarya, Chaturya, Thairya, Dhairya, Saurya, Parakrama and Satyakama. Your Saranagati Gadyam is an imaginary conversation between you and Narayana with Lakshmi. You ask Lakshmi to accept you as favorite devotee of Narayana and you were pardoned for your karma and got moksha. Your Sribhashyam commentary on Brahma Sutras was your first promise, was named by Saraswati herself and conferred on you the title of Bhashyakarar. Your second, when Kureshan named his two sons as Veda, Vyasa and Parashara, and your third was Airar Padi, the 6000 Padi by Pilan. You are hailed as Appanuku Sanghahi Alita Perumal when you proved Tirumala God is Vishnu and not Shiva. You made the Lord adore the Shankhu, Tirumali, Sulam and Damruku to establish the claim. You were the greatest synoptic thinker which the world ever produced. For systematizing Visishtadvaitic philosophy, faithfully interpreting the ancient knowledge in tune with the letter and spirit of the text, in the light of revelation and experience tested by stern logic. You pioneered Visishtadvaita and established the three key principles, Tattva, the knowledge of the three real entities, Jiva, Ajiva and Ishvara, Hita, the means of realization as through Bhakti and Prapatti, Purushartha, the goal to be attained as Moksha or liberation from bondage. You distinguished three Pramanas as valid means of knowledge, Pratyaksha, the knowledge gained by means of perception, Anumana, the knowledge gained by means of inference, and Shabda, the knowledge gained by means of Shruti. You have set three rules of epistemology in acquiring knowledge. Shabda or Shruti, Pramana, occupies the highest position in matters. Anumana occupies the next position, and Pratyaksha yields a definitive position on a particular issue. You explained the relationship between Ishvara, Chit and Achit Brahman. The three ontological entities are Ishvara, Antarvyapi and Bahirvyapi. Chit is the world of sentient beings called Jivas of Nityas, Muktas and Badhas. Achit is the world of insentient entities, especially their non-conscious universe. You established the relationship between Brahman and Jivas and called them Sharira Shariri, Prakara Prakari, Shesha Sheshi, अंशा अंशी अधर्य देवा समंधा नियमाया नियंता एंड रक्षस्या राक्षस का. दीज आर द फादर सन मदर सिस्टर वाइफ हस्बैंड फ्रेंड लवर एंड लॉर्ड. How eloquently you modified the form of Brahma Parinamavada. You illuminated that the Karana, cause, and Karya, effect, is different. Brahman is both the Karana, cause, and the Karya, effect. Brahmana as the cause does not become the universe as the effect. You assigned Brahman to Karana Tvas, ways of being the cause. Nimitta Karanatva, being the efficient instrumental cause. Upadana Karanatva, being the material cause. And all Visishta Dvaitas follow Brahma Prakara Parinama Vada. You made this world understand that the soul is a higher mode than matter. After the death of the body is a communion with God. Liberation through one's karmas, actions, in accordance with the Vedas, individual souls retain their separate identities even after moksha. You emulated that bhakti is the means for attaining moksha. Through bhakti, devotion, a jiva ascends to the realms of the Lord. Karma Yoga and Jnana Yoga are natural outcomes of bhakti, total surrender. As the devotee acquires the knowledge that the Lord is the inner self. You have put forth the view that both the Supreme Goddess Lakshmi and Supreme God Narayana together constitute Brahman, the Absolute. Sri Lakshmi is the female personification of Brahman and Narayana is the male. They are both inseparable, co-eternal, co-absolute and are always substantially one. You brought Govindaraja idol and resurrected again in Tirupati, which was thrown away by Kulothunga Chola, who blinded Kuresa and killed Periya Nambi, mistaking them to be you. Your disciples were happy when they saved you and also died for you. You never entertained any caste distinctions and was conferring your benedictions on every individual from any caste, even on the lowest of the lowly, whom you called Tirukkulathar, and showed them the path of Lord by exampling to show Lord as the most beautiful at the proximity of the image. Your mystic powers were such great heights that when you called Lord, "Come on, my dear child, Selva Pillai Varum," the idol came onto your lap. When the idol was taken away by Muslims and given to their daughter for a play, you reinstalled it in the temple again. You embraced everyone, old, young or child, with equal respect. You received the mud prasad given by young children on the road, who were pretending to play constructing a temple. You remembered the words of Pogind Alwar, "Lord took whatever name and form his sincere devotees wished." Equally, your disciples adored and loved more than Lord himself. Vadugunambi, your close disciple, put your sandals along with those of the Lord. When asked, he replied that the Acharya's sandals were as holy as those of the Lord. He also appreciated seeing you rather than Lord when he is on streets for devotees. Archamurti, known as Tan Ungatta Tirumeni at Tirunarayanapuram, was installed by you, embracing and imbibing your powers in it. Even today you stand with dignity and pujas at par with Lord Venkateshwara. What divine powers and strange strength you possess, as Adisheshu you are. Vishnuvardhana, your Jain disciple, was happy when his daughter was cured by your Sripada Tirtham. By mere touch of your foot, the water became Aushadam, and by your Ashirvadam, Devarayana becomes your disciple Vishnuvardhana. You started many traditions in many temples. You nominated 74 Acharya to succeed you. It is you who instituted the 13-day Iyal Osti in Srirangam. Even after 1,000 years, we do follow all that you taught us. You lived 2 full cycles of divine Hindu years. Born and died in Pingala year after completing 2 cycles. Pingala means Lord of Energy, Gold and Lakshmi. You are the servant of Lord and Lord of we servants. Keeping your head on the lap of Embar and your feet on the lap of Vadugunambi, you have breathed your last listening to the recitation of the Divya Prabandham. Your ascent to Paramapadam was calm, relaxing and peaceful. Who said you have gone? We feel you are in deep sleep. Even today, you are with us physically, mentally, spiritually and socially. Sitting devotedly at Sannidhi, Sanctum Sanctorium, dedicated to you, on the southwest corner, on the 5th round within the Srirangam temple, as ordered by Lord Ranganatha himself. We salute you with adoration and bhakti, as you have many names: Ilaivar, Ramanujar, Yatirajar, Udayvar, Lakshman Muni, Godagrajar, Dikshikendra, Appanuk Sanghai Alitha Perumal, Koyal Annar, Tirupavai Jeer, and Sri Bhasharkar. What's there in name? You are dearer to all of us.